A Nollywood actor is accusing Richard Mofe Damijo of being part of the people who killed Nollywood. According to him, he said, "I loved this man when I was growing up and as a kid, but after joining Nollywood and standing up for what was right in Nollywood, I found out that this man was among the architects who killed Nollywood. RMD was collecting 250K to 400,000 naira just to be in movies. He might say he's doing it for passion because he loves acting, but he was killing the industry with such salary when he was meant to be collecting 5 million naira per movie. If RMD collects 250K to 400K per movie, then tell me how much a lower actor will collect per movie." Yeah, so said his passion killed the industry.
I don't know why he's using kill. Like, it's such a... When I first read it, I thought he... I was hoping for something scandalous. Mm. Like, wow, you know, he's a... I don't know, some big thing. But you have to understand that there's negotiations that happen. And if the person is also bringing 400K, I don't know how you can jump from 400K to 5 million naira. Like, who's actually going to pay that? If the person could, I feel like that would have... been happening, maybe.
Okay, so you don't think this so? Is not the first time I'm hearing this kind of conversation, and the good thing is the first time I can't remember if I was the one who interviewed the man I'm going to mention now, it was somebody else who interviewed him, but it is Alibaba. And if we want to be very sincere with ourselves, we will understand the work that Alibaba has done to actually push the comedy industry in Nigeria to where it is right now. And in that conversation, he mentioned how he deliberately rejected a certain amount of money because he knew that if he did that, the industry would never grow. It's going to become, I mean, if Alibaba is going to collect a 400K, why do I need to go and call somebody else that is upcoming and that is also good to come and collect the same amount, then at the end of the day, they will be limited and probably be getting, say, 20K, 50K, because an Alibaba is getting a 400K. But because to get an Alibaba now, you're talking of millions, even close to that 5 million you're mentioning, it means that he has created an opportunity for other people to grow in that industry. And he said it was a deliberate attempt, because when he was rejecting 400K and 500K, and when you call him, you say, you know what, it's not like he's outrightly going to be rude. He will now call somebody else and say, you know what, I don't have this time now, I'm busy, but this person will do a great job. Because he also could vouch for these people coming up in the industry, that they can deliver a good performance and hold the event. And it worked, because the comedy industry, before the lockdown, I know everybody's affected with the lockdown right now, but before now, I'm telling you that a lot of people are eating comfortably and living comfortably based on just comedy, hosting events and all that. And that's why they respect Alibaba till tomorrow.
I think the comedy industry is still thriving because they are still doing online comedy and stuff that. And so people are still paying.
Maybe he didn't put it right
perfectly.
But the thing is, we need to tell ourselves the truth. And if this is true, because I don't know if he got his facts right.
And I think that this RMD story is happening right now.
That's where I was going to. I don't know if that is what is happening right now.
I saw it as a thing of like when he was younger and 400K.
No, he said he admired him when he was younger. So when he got into the industry...
Did he say today thing?
Like, there was a conversation I was having with an upcoming actor, and he was like, RMD charges about 1 million naira per role. Mm-hmm. Per scene.
Okay.
So for every time he goes on set, you're giving him like 500K, 400K. So if that's what this guy is saying, but I don't want to believe that RMD will travel to Ghana to go and shoot a movie, or travel to Tanzania or wherever to go and shoot a movie, and you would offer him 400K.
Yeah, so I think I like the angle you brought. So I think it is not something that he's happening now, because if it's happening now, then there will be a problem.
There will be a serious problem. And I think
he
will
be able to sustain his lifestyle. I doubt that he's collecting 500K for a movie.
Yeah, because as 2 years ago,
that was me. I saw it like a back then thing. And even back then, I don't think you can compare Alibaba and RMD.
What do you mean?
I mean, in the sense of like them being pioneers of the industry. I don't know. I feel like growing up, I didn't see RMD as much. I saw other people like Jim Iyke and the...
you were not watching movies.
You're not watching... Or maybe not your generation.
Yeah, because I wouldn't have said...
generations are very different.
I wouldn't have seen, RMD a pioneer like I would have called Alibaba a pioneer in the comedy industry. Like, I wouldn't
Well, you might not call him a pioneer, because when it comes to Nollywood and acting, it's not about
Did
one
you see
person.
Olu Jacobs?
There are.
I would say Olu Jacobs.
There are groups
Olu
of
Jacobs
people
and
that have
are
to
probably
make
the same time frame.
Peter Doherty and Olu Jacobs can be in the same. But so that's what I was getting to. So you cannot give one person.
And Peter Doherty was the guy. He was like the guy. Sorry, go on.
Okay, go on.
When it comes to movies, it's not about comedy. Comedy is one person that stands up and doing comedy. But when it comes to a movie, you need people. So they are more like in sets. So if you're calling this veteran, like you're calling an Olu Jacobs, a Peter Doherty comes to mind, or Sophie and Co. Like, when
are you
they
sure we didn't have an RMD
have,
before
so
Peter
an RMD,
Doherty?
I'm trying to remember who is in his clique now. So Ekanayo Okanayo, what's the name of this man now? He's also well bearded and all that. I can't remember his name. Zach Oji.
Yeah.
So people like that. The thing with RMD is that he has this good body that he takes care of himself, and he comes out now and can play the cool boy and can play the older man and can play your sugar daddy and all. But he's actually a man that took even a break in the industry and then come back into
came
back
like,
into
I don't
the
see
industry
him as well, that's like
again.
Like,
so, but he is a big
I feel like he even had like a comeback. I feel like he was silent for a while.
He did
and
have
then
a comeback.
Had a comeback. I can't say that,
that
I'll be looking
wife
for like life changing things in the industry, and I'll point to Arab like.
But his comeback is a big deal.
It
fam,
is.
Right?
It
so
is.
I, maybe he was talking about before now. So if this is what's happening now, then there's a problem. But if it's not happening now, which I don't think is happening now, because I've had conversations where even his condition. Not just his money, his conditions to be on your set is professional and strict. So maybe he should get his facts right before coming out to talk about things.
But
like
if this
right
is
now
what is happening now, please, our A-list actors, please charge them, collect money. It would even help the standard of movies, because if you can pay the actors cheap, then you can shoot anything and just get it out there. But when you know that for this movie, I'm paying each one of them like a huge sum of money, then you would want to get the best out of it. So it would even help our quality of movies. So please charge them. Feel free. Charge even me. Charge me.